Just as the gun goes off, the worst possible scenario happens.
As far as track and field goes, I was pretty, well put together runner. I was pretty successful. I won the county meet, making me the fastest person in our county, and also the district meet, making me the fastest person in our district.
People from my high school would always come up to me like, "Oh, that's Mike." You know, I was that person in the school. I was just known as being the fastest person. You know, that's just who I was. That's just what I identified with. After winning districts, the next big race of my life was regionals. You know, regionals was the deciding factor whether I can go to states and get my chance to win myself a earn a track scholarship to a Division I university track program. I just start to think about, you know, it's my chance now, and I started feeling hype. I started feeling the energy, and then just as the gun goes off, I trip and fall out of my block. After that day, it was a long, depressing bus ride home. And I got home, I didn't even sleep. I was just depressed. I didn't even go to class, contemplating, you know, wishing that I can, you know, be there, wishing that I can be like the people on TV, wishing that I can be great, you know. I was just wishing that I was just born better. Those are the type of things that filled my mind. I just didn't even want to, like, I almost got to the point where I didn't even want to live anymore. My sophomore year, I thought that I would never be able to escape this depression until my sister enrolled at the university too.
Want to try my noodles?
And with that, you know, we roomed together, and from then on, you know, I realized that what it was like to be a student. We ended up making friends, you know, we ended up going out, we ended up having a good time, you know, we went to concerts, we went to Gator nights, we just did all the things that students do. And then one day I met a guy inside Moe's, and he had told me that he had dreams of being on the University of Florida football team. Finally, it came down to my friend's tryout for the team. And in that moment, I realized that, you know, I put that depression to rest when I found the news that he had actually made it. And then with that, a new light came. I realized that I had a love for football too. And I was like, well, if he made it, then so can I. And then I started to train for football. And in the process, this time I didn't train alone. This time I still had a great time doing it. I wasn't too serious, I wasn't too hard on myself. I still maintained a social life. And in the end, it was time for my tryout, and I made it too. And currently now I'm on the UF football team, and I'm number 39. I'm also a running back, and I'm going to practices every day, and I'm enjoying it. I'm just living the life of an athlete, living the dream that I've always wanted to have. And now I feel that, like, I finally found my home. And that home is on the field where I belong.